Okay, now let us discuss about this some questions. Your question is, prove that cosec theta minus cot theta whole square is equal to 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. So we'll show here this left hand side and right hand side are equal. First question, let me to write here at first left hand side of the first question. LHS number 1 LHS cosec theta minus cot theta whole square. Whenever we will deal with this type of problem, one thing you will remember that whatever trigonometric ratios we are given, you will make sure those trigonometric ratios are given in the form of sine, cos or combination of sine and cos or not. If in the question the trigonometric ratios are other than sine, cos, then you will try to bring those trigonometric ratios in the form of sine or cos or combination of sine and cos, whatever is possible. All other trigonometric ratios will try to bring in the form of sine or cos or combination of sine and cos. So here in left hand side we can see our trigonometric ratios are cosec theta minus cot theta, neither sine given nor cos given. So our first work will be to bring this trigonometric ratios in the form of sine and cos. So cosec theta we can write as 1 by sine theta. Cosec theta can be written as 1 by sine theta. If you go through those formulae which I gave just a few minutes ago, there you will get that cosec theta can be written as 1 by sine theta. So in place of this cosec theta, I have written 1 by sine theta. Then minus cot theta. Cot theta, for cot theta, two formulae I wrote. One I wrote as cot theta equal to 1 by 10 theta. But 1 by 10, if we write, then we are not getting in the form of sine or cos or combination of sine and cos. So we don't use that formula. So we'll use another one, cot theta equal to another formula written. If you observe those formulae, you can see cot theta equal to cos theta by sine theta written, another formula. So here we are going to write cot theta as cos theta by sine theta. Cos theta by sine theta. If I am not wrong, it is the last formula which I gave you just a few minutes ago. So cosec theta I have written as 1 by sine theta, then minus, it will remain same in its own place, and cot theta I have written it as cos theta by sine theta, then whole square, it will remain same in its own place. We'll take LCM now, LCM of sine theta and sine theta, that will give sine theta itself. Now LCM sine theta divided by this denominator sine theta, that will give us 1. 1 into numerator 1, that will give us 1, 1 1 0 1 minus. Once again LCM sine theta divided by this denominator sine theta. So sine theta by sine theta gives us 1, 1 is the quotient, into numerator cos theta. So 1 into cos theta, that gives us cos theta. So 1 minus cos theta, and then whole square, it will remain same in its own place. Now we got another formula, basic formula, that A by B whole square. A by B whole square can be written as A square by B square. A by B whole square can be written as A square by B square. So this formula we are going to apply here. One part will get 1 minus cos theta whole square, then divided by sine square theta. So we'll get 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by sine theta whole square, and sine theta whole square, it is nothing but only sine square theta. Actually we are getting here sine theta whole square, then sine theta whole square means sine square theta. Now what is the literal meaning of A square? What is the literal meaning of A square? Anything square, that means the same thing is multiplied twice. That means A square means A into A. So the literal meaning of A square is A into A. So this thing we are going to apply here. 1 minus cos theta whole square means 1 minus cos theta multiplied by again 1 minus cos theta. So we can write it as 1 minus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. 1 minus cos theta into 1 minus cos square cos theta. Then denominator is our sine square theta. sin square theta, that one, if we see our section S formula, there sin square theta is equal to what is written? If you study it carefully, you will get there that sin square theta equal to 1 minus cos square theta written. So, in place of this sin square theta, we can write it as 1 minus cos square theta. 1 minus cos square theta. Now, 1 minus cos square theta, this 1 we can think it as 1 square. 1 can be thought of as 1 square minus cos square theta. You can take the screenshot of it. Okay. Numerator will keep same, that is 1 minus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta, 1 minus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta, and denominator, this 1 can be thought of as 1 square minus cos square theta, 1 can be thought of as 1 square minus cos square theta can be thought of as cos theta whole square. And this thing, if you look carefully, you can see it is in the form of a square minus b square. Have you remembered the formula of a square minus b square? A square minus b square? A square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. A plus b into a minus b. So, here our a is 1 and b is our cos theta. So, in the next line, we will get here 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. So, let us write. Numerator you just keep it same, numerator will remain same. So, 1 minus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta whole thing divided by a square minus b square's formula we are going to apply, which will give us a plus b into a minus b. So, 1 plus cos theta, 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. Observe numerator and denominator, which things are same, exactly same. We can see 1 minus cos theta in numerator, and in denominator also there is 1 minus cos theta. So, same things from numerator and denominator we can cancel, and we are left with now 1 minus cos theta divided by 1 plus cos theta, and this is only we are asked to prove that cosec theta minus cot theta whole square is equal to 1 minus cos theta whole thing divided by 1 plus cos theta. So, this is equal to right hand side proved. So, if you memorize this formula, then this type of problems you can solve it very easily. Now, we will take the second question. You write it quickly. Okay. Let us take the second question. Our second question is, prove that root over 1 plus sin a by 1 minus sin a is equal to sec a plus 10 a. So, like previous one, here also we will start with our left hand side and we will try to get the right hand side. So, let us write the left hand side at first, number 2, left hand side. So, root over 1 plus sin a, 1 plus sin a by 1 minus sin a, root over 1 plus sin a by 1 minus sin a. To get our right hand side sec a plus 10 a, here one step we'll have to do ourselves. We'll multiply denominator and numerator by 1 plus sin a. Since in denominator 1 minus sin a is there, so we'll multiply our numerator and denominator by 1 plus sin a. Just like rationalization, in rationalization to make the denominator rational number, what we did in another lesson, to make the denominator a rational number, we multiply denominator and numerator by the rationalizing factor of denominator, just like that. Here also, we will multiply denominator and numerator by 1 plus sin a. Since here it is minus, So we'll multiply by 1 plus sin a. Had it been 1 plus sin a here, then we would have multiplied it by 1 minus sin a. So in some situations we will have to do this type of steps apart from using formula. So we'll write here 1 plus sin a divided by 1 minus sin a. Then the thing by which we are multiply, we are going to multiply is 1 plus sin a. 1 plus sin a, then by the same thing we will multiply our numerator also, so that as a whole the thing will remain same. 1 plus sin a. So root of r. Now numerator, if you see, we can see the same thing is written twice, 1 plus sin a into 1 plus sin a. So that can be written as 1 plus sin a whole square. We can write it as 1 plus sin a whole square. 1 plus sin a whole square. And denominator, it is in the form of a minus b into a plus b. This one, a minus b into a plus b. So in place of that, we can write a square minus b square. So here our a is 1. So 1 square minus b. B is how much? Yes, it is sin a. So 1 square minus sin a whole square. Square root, it will remain same. Now 1 plus sin a whole square, numerator just keep it same. 1 plus sin a whole square divided by 1 square. 1 square will give us 1 minus sin a whole square, that will give us sin square a. Once again, numerator will keep same, 1 plus sin a whole square. And denominator 1 minus sin square a, group A's formula, if you see, then there you will get that 1 minus sin square a is equal to cos square a. So in place of 1 minus sin square a, we can write cos square a. From the first identity, sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So from there, cos square theta equal to 1 minus sin square theta. Now in place of that theta, here angle is a given. So 1 minus sin square a, we can write it as cos square a. Cos square a. Write it quickly. Okay. Okay, now this 1 plus sin a whole square divided by cos square a will come outside the root. Over 1 plus sin a, there is whole square, so it can come outside the root and we'll get 1 plus sin a. Similarly, cos square a, when it will come outside the root, it will become only cos a. So we'll get now, there will not be any more square root, we'll get 1 plus sin a. 1 plus sin a divided by cos a. So all these squares and this square root are cancelled and we are left with just 1 plus sin a by cos a. Now let us separate this a plus b divided by c. A plus b divided by c can be written as a by c plus b by c. A by c plus b by c. So this thing we are going to apply here. One thing we will get as 1 by cos a. 1 by cos a, and the other thing will get as sin a by cos a. Sin a by cos a. Now 1 by cos a. 1 by cos a is equal to what? Section D's formula, if you see, there you will get 1 by cos a is equal to sec a written. So in place of 1 by cos a, we can write now sec a. In formula, angle was theta, but here angle is a. So 1 by cos a is equal to sec a, and sin a by cos a. In the same section, we will get sin a by cos a, sin theta by cos theta equal to tan theta, but here angle is a, so sin a by cos a, that will give us tan a. Tan a. Now see the right hand side, what is given? We are asked to prove that thing only, sec a plus tan a, and we have got sec a plus tan a. So we can write is equal to RHS proved. Now the third sum we'll take. Write it quickly. Third sum. So number three is we are asked to prove cos A divided by 1 plus sin A plus 1 plus sin A divided by cos A is equal to 2 sec A. We have to prove. So like previous two questions, we have to start with our left hand side. It is not necessary or compulsory that all the time we will have to start with left hand side only. Sometimes we may start with our right hand side also. So it depends upon our convenience. Starting from which side, problem will be easier to solve. So that will be our motto. We should think about that, and depending on our convenience, we can choose whether we'll start with our left hand side or we can start with our right hand side. So here we are going to start with our left hand side. So left hand side, it is cos A by 1 plus sin A. Cos A by 1 plus sin A, then plus 1 plus sin A divided by cos A. Cos A. We'll take LCM. In the very beginning, we'll take LCM. LCM of 1 plus sin A and cos A is product of these two. That means 1 plus sin A into cos A. That will be the LCM. So 1 plus sin A into cos A. 1 plus sin A into cos A is our LCM. Now LCM divided by denominator of this first thing. So what is the denominator of this first thing? It is 1 plus sin A. So when we will divide this LCM 1 plus sin A into cos A by 1 plus sin A, we will get cos A. You see how we are going to divide this LCM, which is 1 plus sin A into cos A divided by whole thing divided by denominator of this first thing, which is 1 plus sin A. So 1 plus sin A. By 1 plus sin A we are going to divide this. So this 1 plus sin A from denominator and from numerator, they are cancelled. So we are left with just cos A. That means our quotient is cos A. So on dividing this LCM by 1 plus sin A, we get cos A as our quotient. So that quotient into numerator is also cos A. So quotient cos A into numerator cos A, that will give us cos square A. Cos square A plus, we'll repeat the same process. We'll divide this LCM by the denominator of the second thing. What is the LCM? LCM, it is 1 plus sin A into cos A. Our LCM is 1 plus sin A into cos A, and denominator of the second thing is cos A. So like earlier, once again we'll have to divide. So in numerator we'll write this LCM, we'll write, which is 1 plus sin A, 1 plus sin A into cos A divided by denominator of the second thing, what is that? Which is our cos A. So in denominator we will write cos A. Now from denominator and numerator, the same thing are cancelled. So cos A are cancelled from denominator and numerator, and we are left with 1 plus sin A. So here 1 plus sin A is our quotient. 1 plus sin A is our quotient. So quotient is 1 plus sin A, and what is the numerator? Numerator is also same, which is 1 plus sin A. So 1 plus sin A into 1 plus sin A, that will give us 1 plus sin A whole square. So here we'll get 1 plus sin A whole square. How we have got 1 plus sin A whole square? Previous line there is no square, but here we have got whole square. How? We divided this LCM by this denominator, which gives us 1 plus sin A as our quotient. That quotient into numerator 1 plus sin A will give us 1 plus sin A into 1 plus sin A, and that 1 plus sin A into 1 plus sin A can be written as 1 plus sin A whole square. Now denominator will keep same, whatever it is we will write the same thing, which is 1 plus sin A into cos A. Numerator, this cos square A, let us keep same, cos square A, plus this 1 plus sin A whole square, So if we observe it, we can see it is in the form of a plus b whole square. So we can apply the formula of a plus b whole square. What is that formula? A plus b whole square. A plus b whole square's formula. A plus b whole square is equal to a square plus twice ab plus b square. A square plus twice ab plus b square. So this formula we are going to apply here. 1 plus sin a whole square. Here our a is 1 and b is how much? B is our sin a. So we can write here 1 square. So a square we have written, this a square written, then plus twice ab. So plus 2 into a. A how much? It is 1. So 2 into 1 into b. B how much here? B it is sin a. So 1 into sin a. Plus at last it is b square. So b means our sin a. So we have to write here sin a whole square. Sin a whole square. Denominator keeps same without doing anything. So 1 plus sin a into cos a. Numerator this cos square a keep it same. Plus 1 square that will give us 1. Plus 2 into 1 into sin a. What is the product of 2 into 1 into sin a? 2 1 are 2. And then into sin a, that gives 2 sin a. So altogether product we are getting as 2 sin a. Then plus sin a whole square. So sin a whole square means sin square a. Sin a whole square is equal to sin square a. We will get here sin square a. In next line we will make group. This sin square a plus cos square a will keep in one group, and with the other things they will remain same. And denominator, the denominator also will remain same. Write it quickly. So we'll get, as I've already told, we'll make group with sin square a and cos square a. So let us write. Sin square a plus cos square a, make it one group, and remaining two things you keep it separately. So which is plus 1 plus 2 sin a, plus 1 plus 2 sin a, whole thing divided by denominator, just carry it without doing anything. So 1 plus sin a into what? Cos a into cos a, cos. Have you remembered the value of sin square a plus cos square a? Sin square a plus cos square a, first identity. There we got sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So in place of this thing we can write 1. So 1 plus remaining two things, just write them same. 1 plus 2 sin a, this also will remain same. Denominator keep it same, 1 plus sin a into cos a. 1 plus sin a, then into cos a. In next line also denominator you just keep same, it is cos a. 1 plus sin a into cos a, keep it same. And numerator 1 plus 1, so 1 plus 1 will get 2. This 1 plus 1, 2 plus this 2 sin a. Observe numerator carefully, 2 plus 2 sin a. What can you take common? Clearly 2 can be taken as common. So on taking 2 common inside bracket, here we will be left with 1 plus, and here we will be left with sin a. So 1 plus sin a, whole thing divided by 1 plus sin a into cos a. So look at the numerator and denominator. 1 plus sin a in numerator and in denominator also 1 plus sin a. So same thing from numerator and denominator are cancelled. So we are left with just 2 divided by cos a. We are left with 2 divided by cos a. 2 divided by cos a. Thank you. Now 2 divided by cos A, 2 divided by cos A can be written as 2 into 1 by cos A. 2 into 1 by cos A. So 2 into 1 by cos A, again in that last section, that means section D, I think, we got 1 by cos A is equal to sec A. So in place of this 1 by cos A, we can write sec A. Now 2 into sec A, it is nothing but 2 sec A. Now if you look at the question, you can see in right hand side we are asked to prove that that left hand side is equal to, and right hand side given 2 sec A. So which we have got 2 sec A. So we can write equal to RHS proved. So if we know this formula, then this type of any problems we can solve very easily. Thank you for watching our video.